XFM News. On point. Look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. The Forum for Democratic Change President Patrick Omoyer wants the ballot papers for the 2021 general elections printed from outside the country to guarantee some level of credibility, noting that this will prevent ballot stuffing. He said a local company printing ballot papers puts the whole electoral process in jeopardy.
Justice Byabakama and your team, we are putting you on notice as the FDC to carry out and supervise this process meticulously. Otherwise, if they don't do that, the blood of the Ugandan people will be on their hands.
And their feet too.
Yes, and probably their feet, maybe their backs as well. Therefore, we are watching the process of printing of ballot papers because we begin to smell a rat about what may happen with these ballot papers.
The president of the National Unity Platform, Robert Kyagulanyi, has pledged to improve the lives of older persons once entrusted with the office of the presidency. Kyagulanyi made the pledge at Pakwach Town Council during his first campaign and promised to uplift the lives of these suffering older persons across the country. He further pledged to increase access to facilities and health centers and salaries of health workers.
I know what all the old people are going through all over northern Uganda and in particular in West Nile. Our fathers, our mothers, our grandfathers, our grandmothers and all the elders are going to go. My government will be a government that treats our elders like our elders. We have a national budget that caters for the elderly, but unfortunately, it is only those that are related to Museveni that are treated as elderly.
A Court of Appeal session has kicked off at the Fort Potter High Court, Kabarore District. The Court of Appeal session is being presided over by three justices led by Justice Kenneth Kakuru. The other justices on the panel, Justice Christopher Madrama and Irene Miyagonja. Early before the session started, the presiding justices visited Katoja Prison and interacted with some of the inmates. Justice Kakuru, the presiding judge, told the inmates that appealing against the High Court ruling was their constitutional right. A total of 40 criminal appeals are up to be heard, according to Ayebade Tumwebaze, Court of Appeal Deputy Registrar. Seven community development officers from Nakaseke District have been arrested for allegedly soliciting bribes from residents who register for the government economic empowerment project dubbed Emyoga. The suspects were arrested on the directives of the Minister for Microfinance, Haruna Cheine Kasolo, who received complaints from the residents. The district police commander, Sulait Chitaka, says investigations into the matter are still going on.
We are holding them on extortion. It is alleged that the suspects in our custody involved themselves in extorting money from Wananchi in order to be registered on the ongoing program of job creation and wealth creation, which is normally known as skilling or Emyoga. Our inquiries are kicked off, and this followed the interface that they had yesterday with the Minister for Microfinance, Honorable Minister Haruna Kasolo, who ordered for their arrest.
In other news, Donald Trump has accused the Food and Drug Administration of deliberately delaying work on a coronavirus vaccination in order to thwart his re-election hopes. On Monday, Pfizer announced that their vaccination was proved to be 90% effective in clinical trials. The data will now go to the FDA for approval, and once the FDA gives the green light, a mass vaccination program can begin. Donald Trump Jr. said the timing was nefarious and was because his father was hated by the pharmaceutical industry for forcing them to lower their prices. On Monday night, the president accused the FDA of seeking to sabotage his campaign too. The FDA is led by a commission appointed by the president. I quote, "The FDA and the Democrats did not want to have me get a vaccine win prior to the election, so instead it came out 5 days later, as I've said all along," he tweeted. His tweet came as FDA authorized emergency use of Eli Lilly and company's experiment, a COVID-19 antibody treatment, which Trump has praised and vowed to make available free of cost for all America. And that was the news.
XFM News on point.